Hey all, in this video I want to talk about the prospects of battery swapping technologies in China and for Tesla. I think there is a chance that the next Tesla vehicle that will be developed in China will be having this technology. And of course, I don't mean it in a way that you can see in this video because this is just some CGI rendering, but Tesla already had the battery swapping technology in the past and Elon was pitching it as customer-centric solution to eliminate the pain of charging time, battery degradation and swapping for defect batteries.
We should preserve the optionality. So what if people do want to, switch out their battery pack? What if they only want to stop for a short period of time? And when you come to the Tesla station, it shouldn't be really called the supercharging station. It should just be called the Tesla station. You have the choice of the supercharger, which is and always will be free, or you have the choice of a battery pack swap.
However, for Tesla, it never took off.
We have the LA to San Francisco pack swap capability in place. And I believe all Model S owners in the sort of California area have been invited at this point to try it out. And what we're seeing is just a very low take rate for the pack swap station. So we did an initial round of invitations where we did basically like 200 invitations, and I think there were a total of 4 or 5 people that wanted to do that, and they all did it just once. So, okay, it's clearly not very popular.
Instead, the technology was revived by the Shanghai-based startup NIO in China, which made battery swapping a unique feature of their cars. Now, why could battery swapping have a second revival, and this time in China? And why could Tesla choose to adopt this technology again? Well, first, we have to acknowledge the fact that China is an inherently different market to, for instance, the US. Many people are living in high-rise compounds. Wall boxes for home charging are partly no viable solutions, and if you have to drive to superchargers in the city to charge your EV, this can become costly, time-consuming and painful experiences. Furthermore, in China, labor cost is generally lower for simple jobs. This has developed a vivid service culture. Whenever I'm in China, I'm experiencing it everywhere. In restaurants, in malls or at train stations, there is a noticeable service upgrade in comparison to Germany. There is always enough service personnel around to make you comfortable and to offer you even the tiniest services. Therefore, Chinese consumers have kind of a different service expectation in contrast to their Western peers, and in general, convenience plays a much higher role and is also at a different service level. So NIO is a user enterprise and highly customer-oriented company. In order to innovate and to become a lifestyle company that caters the needs of China's newly rich middle class and premium users, a high convenience and service experience is at the core of NIO's business model. This is why NIO has adopted battery swapping as a China-centric solution to foster EV adoption among skeptics. This is why NIO made swapping one option besides supercharging and home charging as a couple of more options here. And the numbers speak for itself. Today, NIO has completed 800,000 swaps with 50% penetration rate. So in contrast to Tesla, NIO in China has found that battery swapping adds value for their users. Initially, a great idea to bring down charging times, eradicating the pain of battery degradation and broken batteries, as shared by the views of Elon Musk too, it seems that the swapping has a future in the Chinese market. Now, why would have Tesla possibly second thoughts about adopting this technology again? Well, first of all, Elon Musk was smart enough to announce that in China, Tesla would build an entirely new car from scratch, designed for this new and important market.
We create a China design and engineering center to actually design an original car in China for worldwide consumption. You know, try something just like kind of radical, like Cybertruck, Nobody was expecting that.
On top of that, NIO has taken battery swapping a step further and has built a powerful business model around it called Battery as a Service, in brackets BaaS. Essentially, what NIO is doing is separating the vehicle from its battery and selling the car while allowing to lease the battery separately. This brings down the initial price of the car, allowing NIO to tap into new customer segments that previously couldn't afford EVs. Furthermore, to establish the circle for battery as a service, NIO has founded a new entity with stakeholder like battery manufacturer and supplier CATL, which by the way also supplies Tesla with batteries, as well as Chinese investment banks and local governments as investors. This new entity will manage battery assets and bring them into the circle of swapping stations powered by NIO Power and open to other manufacturers. Basically, a new standard for swapping will become a national standard in China. And this is really powerful. It means that the government will be part of helping to build up the required swap stations and the standardization for the leasing, the swapping technology and related taxes and subsidies will be rolled out as a powerful incentive scheme to become part of it. Already today, NIO cars are exempt from the NEV subsidies pricing thresholds because the subsidy rules make an exemption for battery swapping. This means all NIO models get the subsidies despite being more costly than the threshold, and Tesla needs to lower their purchase prices to even apply for it. Also, as we know famously, with the ongoing China-US trade war, China is a master of creating their own national heroes. Policies and compliance rules are used to protect and support national companies. China will never directly forbid foreign companies like happening with TikTok in the US. Instead, they will leave the option of complying with national standards, for instance, internet censorship. So companies like Microsoft, who adopted to those national rules, are permitted to stay. Companies who choose not to do so, like Facebook and Google, are basically non-existent in the Chinese market. So I think German car OEMs will be forced to adopt battery swapping too, if the national standard becomes powerful. The market is just too important to them, and we already see SAIC, the joint venture of Volkswagen in China, to introduce models with swapping functionality. So unfortunately, this is how protectionism works in China, and it is unfair, but either you comply with the national rules or your products and services are excluded from this big market. Therefore, I believe this new business model has the power to force other OEMs to become part of the scheme, and the decreased upfront service price, benefits like the redundancy and interchangeability, the effects on the resale value of the car, and the simple customer centricity of the solution, alleviating so many pain points of Chinese consumer, are just too powerful to not adopt it. And I think this time Musk will probably not ignore this, as he is thinking customer-centric too, and he would also remember that Tesla has higher goals than just to crush competition. In addition to that, during the last conference call, Musk also said that the things that bugs him the most is that EVs need to become cheaper and more affordable, so this is possible with the BaaS business model. And Musk has emphasized several times that he would rather accelerate the advent to sustainable mobility by cooperating and by sharing technology to increase EV adoption than just to make Tesla the only winner here. And if we take Elon Musk here by his words, he should actually become a stakeholder of the battery asset management company, which is actually open to that, and should join NIO and CATL as shareholders in this company. On the other hand, we also need to consider that this is definitely just a China-specific solution. In other words, battery swapping may never get accepted or a thing in Western countries. Western consumers just have different standards and different needs as well. And furthermore, we have the big question what Tesla will be introducing during Battery Day. Maybe Tesla comes up with new technology that makes charging less of a pain point and increases longevity of batteries, thereby taking some wind out of the sails of battery swapping. But generally, the advantage of battery swapping technology is also that this new battery tech can be introduced into any fleet simply by swapping it. However, if Tesla has truly a breakthrough in battery tech, would they be ready to share it beyond their own cars and give this technology, for instance, into a BaaS service model, so that even NIO and other OEMs can use the technology and swap it into their cars? I don't know the answer to it. It's too early and I cannot say it for sure. In the end, I think Elon Musk and Tesla have all the cards in the hand, and it comes up towards their strategy and what they are deciding to do. However, Musk should be able to see the power of this new battery as a service business model that NIO has brought onto the stage here, and where they have the consumer adoption and consent. No matter how it ends, I do think that Tesla Tesla and NIO will be the winner either way, collaborating or by going their own ways. Both have their unique advantages, which are defendable in both ways, much in contrast to their competitors. And this is why I am long and stay invested in both Tesla and NIO.